wheels and brakes removal and installation. Before starting the work, make sure that all safety measures have been taken, that is, hydraulic systems depressurized, landing gear control lever down and safety locked, parking brake as required, corresponding circuit breakers safetied and tagged. On the left-hand side of the aircraft, open the landing gear door to gain access to the parking brake accumulators and depressurize them completely using the relief valve lever. Landing gear safety locks are installed. Travel ranges of the landing gear are cleared. Lift the related axle with jacks. Now remove the wheel itself. Caution, fully deflate the wheel. Remove the debris guard assembly attached by means of 6 screws along the wheel axle to prevent damage of the drive shaft of the tachometer. Remove the shroud retained by 2 screws. Remove the lock wire. Lock the impeller by inserting a tool into the rim to prevent shroud support damage. Unscrew the nut and pull the impeller. Disconnect the connector of the tire pressure transducer. Remove the clamp and the shroud support. Remove the split pin securing the safety screws of the wheel locking nut. Unscrew the safety screws of the wheel locking nut. For the next screw, turn the tire pressure transducer to allow the safety screw to be released. Unscrew the wheel nut using the appropriate tool and remove it. Fit the protection tool onto the wheel axle and grease it. Remove the wheel. Now let's remove the brake unit. Disconnect the hydraulic coupling. Remove the quick release pin securing the harness of the temperature sensor. Disconnect the temperature sensor connector and pull out the harness from the housing. Disconnect the other hydraulic coupling. Now remove the brake rod, securing the brake unit on the bogey beam axle. Remove the split pin. Unscrew the safety screw securing the collar and drive out the pin using an appropriate tool. Remove the collar and drive out the torque pin from the brake piston housing. Remove the brake assembly by sliding it carefully along the wheel axle. Secure the brake rod on the bogey beam axle. Removal is now completed. The wheel and brake assembly is installed according to the sequence opposite to that applied for removal. Place the brake unit, having previously cleaned the axle with appropriate solvent, and grease it. Place the wheel. Place the wheel nut so that the safety screws can be fitted freely. Fit the shroud support and the clamp, bearing in mind the setting of the tire pressure transducer. Install the impeller, the shroud, and the debris guard. Removal and installation of the wheel and brake are now completed.